Hello and welcome, everyone. Hello and welcome, everyone, to the $140,000 Keyflow Feeds USA CSI 3-Star Grand Prix here at week 2 of the Winter Equestrian Festival at Wellington International. I'm your host, Danny Waldman, and I'm thrilled to be here presenting our live stream. This week's title sponsor for this CSI 3-Star here at Wellington International is Keyflow USA. We provide the tools for horses to perform their very best from the inside out. It's our passion and our mission. We've got 45 horse and rider combinations coming forward for today's 3-Star Grand Prix. I took a look at the course, and it looks like it's delicate out there. But I think it looks jumpable, and I'm excited to see what some of the riders can do. We've got a strong field. McLean Ward starting us out. Jad Dano's been on fire recently. We've got Ben Mayer coming up on his 5-star winning mount. Shane Sweetnam, who jumped a great qualifier round. And, of course, Friday's shared winners with Amanda Derbyshire and Abigail McCardle. It is about 65 degrees and a little chilly and windy out there, but at least the sun is shining, and it's going to be a great day of show jumping. At least it's not raining. It's been a very wet week here, but we are excited to see what the riders can do. Course is set at meter 50, but I think some of the jumps look a little bit taller. And there we go. Let's take a look at the course. Going to start off the right lead up at the far end. Vertical long run down to number 2, maybe about 10 strides or so. Then left-handed turn to the oxer on the side by the scoreboard. Left-handed to that airy wall. And then it walks 5 strides up to the Liverpool Oxer. We'll see how that rides. And then it's a right-handed turn, kind of blind, around the Liverpool to number 6. And then right-hand turn, one of the more difficult parts on the course, the option at 7. There's 2 jumps they could jump. Left-handed turn, Oxer, 2-stride vertical, Oxer, 1-stride in the triple, then 4 strides to number 9, heading right at the bank, right-handed turn in the corner to the skinny. Then I think it'll be 8 strides down to 11, and then, of course, 7 to this very difficult vertical Oxer double at the end. And then you're not done. Left-handed bend, 7 strides to a tall vertical at 13. So a lot of jumping to be done. Delicate double at the end. I think that's going to come down a lot. But we'll see how many go clear of this 45 horse and rider field. First up is going to be McLean Ward and First Lady, an appropriate name for this first horse. Okay, First Lady is owned by Robin Parsky, 11-year-old mare by Don DiRado with a Lord Danos mother. All right, let's see what he does here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, so a nice simple 10, 1 to 2. This is a very sporty horse that McLean is on. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 to the wall. Does the 5 to the Liverpool. Maybe gets there a little bit early. And then this sort of blind turn to the orange oxer in the corner. Has the front pole of that. And now we'll take a look at this option at 7. There's 2 Liverpools. There, one is in the ground as a ditch, and one sits on top. Different colored poles than the triple. Oxer vertical, 2 stride, then 1 stride. Does the 4. Has C coming out of the triple. Then you can see McLean just taking his time and organizing. Three down so far. Jumps the skinny. 8. Does the 7. Steadies up. Jumps through the hard double. And then really stays on it in the 7 to the last. He'll finish up time 82.37 with the 3 down for a total of 12 faults to get us started here in the Keyflow Feeds CSI 3-star Grand Prix. So maybe not the start McLean would have liked, but we'll keep an eye on this time allowed and see how the rest of this works out. Okay, second is going to be Catherine A. Dynan and the Grant Road Partners LLC and Daniel Schwartz entry, Brago RMB. 2006 Dutch bred gelding Bynamalis with a Gerlinas mother. All right. Different camera angle here. She also does the 10. Here's the Hermes Oxer at number 3. Beautiful jump. Does 10 here. Does the 5. Gets a little bit more space than McLean had there. And then this difficult one gets right up to the base but jumps that beautifully. Again, Katie's won a World Cup qualifier on this horse. She chooses the same option as McLean, which is the in-ground ditch Liverpool versus the one that sits above the ground. 2 sits up there good. Uses her upper body to help at B. It's very tall vertical at B. Much, much taller, actually, than the Oxer coming in. And now roll back to this skinny. She's looking good so far. Does the 8. 7 in. Vertical Oxer jumps out great. Moves up a little bit to the 7. Oh, and there we go. All right. Time 81.31. Big smile on her face. You can see that's a great clear round to get us started here in the 3-star Grand Prix. Katie, you can see very, very happy. That was a beautiful round. I think the horse jumped great. Yeah, big hug there. Nice to see her appreciating her equine partner. All right, and we will move on to our next one in the order, Belgium's Emily Conter and the Steffex Stables owned entry, Trixie Z. 10-year-old Zangerside mare by Tobago and Willem Mother. So looking like everybody's just going to do that nice, simple 10 from 1 to 2. I think it's not so important if they do 10, 9, 11, whatever it is. But they just have to know that if they do one more stride, could mean that the horse a little bit behind their legs. But she looks pretty good so far. Gets right up there in the 5. Lands a little bit. Has to stay on it. This is actually working out quite well. When I walked it, I thought, ooh, that's a really blind turn. But there's enough strides in there, about 9, so they have a chance to recover. So she's choosing the other option at the Liverpool. That one has black and gray poles, but the Liverpool is not set in the ground, so it's just sitting on top of the grass. There she has the tall vertical at B coming down. Looking good here. Bit of an angle at 10, and she has to land and kind of stay on it. In the 8, little reach across the key flow, feeds, jump, sits up here. Double's actually riding quite well. I thought it was going to be really delicate. Just stays on the 7. finishing up in a time of 80.81. But with the one down at B of the triple, she'll finish up on four faults for Emily Conter. All right. So one clear so far. We've seen three jump. All right. Nice pause here. Back up. Checking those brakes. Making sure she's ready. And she being Lacey Gilbertson of the USA. She's sitting on Demsel Saint-Hermel, the Seabrook LLC farm entry of the 11-year-old Selle-Francais mare by uppercut with the Paladine mother. Former ride of Shane Sweetums. But let's see what Lacey can do. She went a little bit outside on the track, was on the counter canter, so she had to move up a little bit in that 10. Big jump there. You can see her put her land and put her leg on. The horse was stalling a little bit. She's going to have to slow up here. Really good ride there. You can see her really put energy in the horse right at the end to make sure it gets over it. Same thing here. Horse jumping up high. Lacey having to ride strong right at the base. She's doing a good job kind of digging in deep and making sure she gets there. Steadies up. She chooses the left side as well. Big discussion with the riders. The ground sometimes at that inset one can be a little bit mucky and rough. It looks okay at the beginning, but it can get worse as the course goes. She also has Bia the triple. That was a big thing when I walked the course. First thing I thought was, whoa, B is tall, a lot taller than anything else. And I think that's the course designer, Olaf Peterson Jr.'s. That was what his plan was, to set it tall and make it hard to jump. Jumps in good, big jump out. Stays on the 7. And she will finishing a time at 81.10 with the 4 faults. So it's a little bit slower than Emily's, I believe, but finishing in the 4 faults. All right, so it's looking solid so far. We've seen B of that triple come down a couple of times, but let's see if our reigning Olympic champion, Ben Mayer, and Vegas Dallas Battili. Can go for the clear. Ben has won a 5-star Grand Prix on Dallas Vegas Battili before. It's been a really strong horse for him over this past summer. Big time jumper. I believe this is the horse he jumped the Nations Cup in Aachen on. Let's see which option he chooses. Also the left side. So that's the above ground one with the black and gray poles. I honestly thought both options were quite difficult to jump. Neither of them would look friendlier than the other. Oh, unfortunate rail there coming out. It really pushed off the ground, jumped up high, but landed a tiny bit shallow. Coming down on that back pole of C of the triple. Steadies up for the 7 so he could keep the energy up for the vertical coming in. Sits up here, jumps over the last. Quick time, 79.13, but on the 4 faults, sitting in 2nd place behind our clear round at the moment. So it was a quick round, but unfortunately with that later fault at C of the triple, that will keep Ben Mayer out of our jump off. You can see, looking like it was a solid round, but knowing Ben, he will have hoped for the clear. All right, moving on. Bennett actually moved up in our order, and we will go back to our original fifth in the order, USA's 27-year-old Spencer Smith. Spencer Smith is sitting on HHS Seattle, 11-year-old Irish bred gelding by owned by Ashland Farms, by Pacino out of the Cavalier Royale mother. I was watching Spencer warm this horse up earlier in the day, and it is quite a big horse. Spencer himself is a really tall guy, so I actually didn't realize how big of a horse this is. But it is 11 years old, but he does say he can get a little bit green, not so much experience at this level, but a very capable animal. Let's see if Spencer can assure us of a jump off. Again, we're sitting on the one clear so far with Katie Dynan and Brego R&B. Nice simple 10. Jumps the wall. Big horse like this. Spencer just steadying, kind of patient, all five strides. Just maybe a little bit on the angle as he take off there. Like I said, that is really blind turn. If you don't get perfectly straight to it, it's kind of easy to end up a little bit closer in the distance than you expected. Remember, an angle will make you a little bit closer. Just having the back pole coming in there. Just lost a little bit of power as he took off at A. Little bit deep there, maybe at the skinny. Again, big horse. And there, just fits a short stride in. Actually helped the horse jump that beautifully. Was real tight there, but the horse got really used his body. Steadies up there also just a little bit. Maybe just taking him a little bit past those distances. He'll finish up time 82.32 with the four down, 16 faults for Spencer Smith and HHS Seattle. So just maybe going for a little bit more rideability, but like he said, a little bit green sometimes at this level. Okie dokie, moving on. Now we've got Zoe Conter of Belgium. We saw her sister Emily jump a couple of rounds ago, but now it's Zoe's turn. Zoe's sitting on La Yuna, 13-year-old mare by Choco Blue with the Four Pleasure mother owned by Steffex Stables out of Belgium. Saw a lot of people talking the other night about safety vests, and Zoe is one of those riders that's wearing them. It's not mandatory at high-level competition yet. However, more and more riders are wearing them, and if it were up to me, it would be mandatory. I think it's a great thing for safety, but it's nice to see many more international riders wearing the safety vests. Why not protect yourself since we have the technology? Looking good so far. Steadies up, a little bit close to the front there, but no problem. Good there. You can see her making the adjustments, trying to fit that stride in. She gets it done. She's also going for the left side. Actually, interesting story. A lot of the, initially it was not an option at seven, but a lot of the riders sort of talked to the course designer and said, you know what, the ground can get a little bit rough at the in-ground Liverpool, and they asked to have an option built. So the option was put in, and now riders can choose whatever they want. She does have B of that triple, that vertical that we're seeing come down a lot already early on in this course. Big jump there at the key flow feeds. Also, big jump in, jumps that good. Stays on this, sits up at the last. Oh, unfortunately, that coming down as well. She'll finish up at a time of 80.47 with the two down for eight faults for Zoe Conter and La Yuna. All right, so we've got scene one clear so far. But B of that triple proving to be one of the most difficult courses, jumps to jump on the course. All right, let's see what Alex Matz, the 27-year-old American rider, can do on his mount, Junior Cannon, owned by Dorothy A. Matz. It's a 10-year-old Dutch bred gelding by Cannon with the Dean Montesemoli mother. Again, this horse, 10 years old. The Cannons, of course, we always see maybe a little bit slower to develop. So 10 years is just at the cusp of them really coming into their own. This horse in the past was seen by another rider who we'll see later in the class, Richard Vogel. So he rode this horse in the past, but now Alex has the ride. Beautiful jump there. You can see the horse jerked his front knees up, finished well behind. Wow, great jump. This is a beautiful, beautiful jumper. Look at that shape. Great jump there. Again, well-bred Cannon Diamant. A lot of Scopey breeding. We see a lot of sort of big-time sport horses with Cannon and Diamant in the pedigree. It's looking good so far. Let's see if we can leave B up. Sits up. Oh, great reaction for the horse. Little tucks his hind end in there at the end. Alex does a great job to add his leg, make sure he gets across it. You could tell the horse was thinking, oh, it looks far away to get out. But oh, a little bit deep here. Oh, just not able to finish that stride and get the hind end out of the way. Loses balance tiny bit there on landing. Big, strong kick out. This horse jumping up real high. Alex adding his leg to the last, gets over it. Time is 80.02, but with that late fault at the skinny, he will have to settle for four faults. That was actually a beautiful round. Horse jumped great. And I think Alex really rode strong. He was really on it. You know, he knew where he needed to add leg. Just unfortunately, sometimes when you come around those rollback turns, things just don't come out up exactly the way you want. He was just a little bit too deep, and the horse couldn't quite finish that stride and get the hind end out of the way. But good pet. I think that's going to be a nice horse in the future. Really incredible shape jump. Beautiful bascule to that jump. All right, moving on to our Lebanese rider, Jat Dana. He has been absolutely incredible recently, winning our meter 50 last week and won the National Grand Prix week one. Let's see what he can do on ABC Quantum Cruise. Owned by Ronnie Beard and Winmont, 2009 Irish bred gelding. Biobios quality with the Quickstar mother. One thing you know about Jad, he's going to fight to the end to try to leave those jumps up. Big distance there. He's going to have to slow down. Whoa, real deep there. Good job. Get it done. And again, here, you can see the horse really taking him to the jumps and him having to really hold him back, not let him overtake the distance. Horse gets real excited to go to the jump. Oh, just gets there a little bit on the angle, a little bit too deep. As the horse was sort of dragging him to it, he was trying to slow him down, but just a little bit on that angle, a little bit too deep. And there, a little bit too, you can see the horse just taking him a little bit past. Losing the balance a little bit. Gets up over this. A little bit shifty there on landing. Good jump there at the Oxer. Trying to get him back. Little touch coming in. That stays up. You can see there the horse's balance a little bit down. Gonna have to leave it. There we go. Gets over the last. But we'll finish up with the two down. Eight faults. 76 is the time. Okay, so still sitting on the one clear with Katie Dynan and Brego R&B. Again, triple proving to be very difficult. And even though we have a strong field of horses and riders out there today, a lot of jumping that needs to be done. And of course, we've been out on the field all week here for the FEI competitions, but we've been in the sand ring in the past couple of weeks, you know, for people warming up and jumping the premier week and week one. So this is a big difference in stamina test for the horses, especially if they've had a bit of the fall off And now they have to come out here and keep the stamina with these longer time allowed and a lot of big galloping around the field. Let's see if USA's 24-year-old Raleigh Hiller can add her name to the good list with Oboros Chloe, the Kurt Hiller entry of the 2011 Mare by Chaco Blue. Former ride of Marlon Zanatelli's. But Scopey horse here. German bred, of course, that Chaco Blue. And the La Capo on the mother's side is a stallion out of Holstein. Didn't breed that much, but it's been looking good. Really Scopey horse here. Stays on that inside track there to the orange. As long as there's enough space on takeoff, I actually kind of like that. The way that that's working out. A little bit smoother in the rhythm. Tight, light touch there. You could see the pole rolling in the cups. Whoa, that was a big distance coming in. And then it catches up with her at B, unfortunately. You need to be extra balanced coming in there at A because B is so tall and delicate to jump. She took a very big distance coming into the triple. That's why B came down. Nice there. She stays very soft on takeoff. Big Scopey horse, this. And clears the last. Finishes up time of 83.28, and with the four faults and the one time fault. So she is just over that time allowed of 83 seconds and picking up the five for a total. All right. Let's see our next coming up. Looking like Andrew Wells. There he is, taking a deep breath. Another great safety feature we're seeing out there. He's not only got the airbag vest on, but also the helmet with the ear protectors. It's great to see more and more safety gear. All right, Andrew Wells is sitting on Idle H&H, the Evergreen Stables LLC, and Itasca Group LLC entry of the 11-year-old Dutch-bred gelding by Action Breaker with the Glenridge mother. Ooh, hard rub at one. Luckily, that stays up. Hard, kind of simple vertical to start us out. Sometimes verticals are actually harder to jump than oxers in the beginning of courses. Horses just kind of jump them casually. So luckily he touched it, but it stays up. Nice strong ride there at the wall. Beautiful jump there at the oxer. Gets nice and straight to this. Great jump. You could see coming to it. He set that up well. You knew he was going to jump it well because of the way he set it up. Steadies up. He does the natural option on the right. Again, the one on the left, the above ground one, has black and gray poles. The natural one has solid white poles. So you got to pick and choose for your horse what you think is the best option. Jumps through the triple. Great. Clears that, getting a little bit lower. He's got to get the balance back here for the delicate white skinny. Clears it. Yeah, jumps that one. Great. Now this delicate double. Clears A. Strong jump across B. One more to go. He looks okay on the time. Jumps the last, and there we go. Clear round, 81.01, and we are assured of a jump off. So second clear of the class so far, 10th to go in the order. Andrew Wells and Idle H&H adding their name to the good list. So we got Catherine Dynan and Andrew Wells assuring us of a jump off. All right, next up, we've got USA's 30-year-old rider, Adrian Sternlicht. She's sitting on Origa Van H. Zoud Pajotenland. That is a Belgian sounding name. Owned by Starlight Farms LLC. 10-year-old Belgian bred gelding by Thunder van de Zutova with the Ogonicita mother. So just 10 years old, this horse. But I've seen this horse a little bit with Adrian, and it's looking like it's going to be a good one for her. Big jump there. Gets right to the base in the 10. Adrian's been working with Jeroen Dubbeldam. Dutch rider, ooh, just a little bit too deep there. Steadies up and then adds a little bit more leg to get over the Liverpool. Again, this horse just 10. Remember, we're in the very beginning of the year. It's just January, so it may not actually even be 10. Its actual birthday could be a little bit later just because of the breeding seasons with horses. And so still young for this age and this level. But definitely a scopey horse. Sits up there. You can see her land. Put her leg on. Think about that time allowed. A little bit of an angle. That worked out well. Steady up in the 7. Horse has a big lopey stride. Gets over the last, but does have that one down at the wall. So 4 faults, time is 81.11 for Adrian Sternlich and Origa. And I don't think she'll be too upset with that round. Like I said, just a 10-year-old coming up to this level. And you can see, I think she said that was pretty good. All right, moving on. Looking like Ben Mayer had moved up in our order, so we will move on to USA's Quinton Judge. Quinton Judge is sitting on HH Zorro Z. HH Zorro Z is an 11-year-old gelding by VDL Zorroco Blue with the Escudo 1 mother, owned by the Double H Farm. Big jump there at 2. This horse, you can see, has a nice kind of slow, lopey gallop and a big scopey jump. There, he's just balancing up. Choose to do one more there to the wall. Actually helps set up his 5 beautifully. Stays on it here to the orange. Then he gets right back in the saddle and says, okay, we got to keep moving. Time allowed. Choosing the black and silver above ground Liverpool for his option. Jumps that. Can he jump this? Oh, just look like he having both B and C a little bit on the way up. Same thing there. Just not able to get back in the 4 stride. So can snowball quite quickly. Is 3 down right there in a row. Just looking like the horse having them on the way up. Not enough space to get over them. I think this horse wants a lot of space. When he has the time, he can really jump around the jumps. But there, when he ends up a little bit too close, can't quite get his body out of the way. A little bit of a touch at the last. That stays up. But he will finish up with 4 down, total 16 faults, 81.83 for Quinton Judge and HH Zorro Z. Again, thanks to this week and this class's title sponsor here at Wellington International, Keyflow USA. We provide the tools for horses to perform their very best from the inside out. It's our passion and our mission, and we thank Keyflow for their support of the Winter Equestrian Festival. All right, next up, 35-year-old from the USA, Hannah Selick. Hannah Selick is sitting on the 13-year-old Holsteiner gelding Cloud 39, owned by Descanso Farm. by Claremo out of the Quintero Mother. This is a fan favorite because it is such a spectacular partnership between these two. And it was clear with the time fault in our qualifier, but this horse has jumped some huge classes with Hannah. And absolutely love this animal and watching this partnership. Oh, what an unfortunate fault. You don't normally see a mistake like that between these two. Just, you can see, he jumps up so high. Normally, not having to worry about the back pole. But just touched that one at the Hermes Oxer. So now she's going to want to stay on. Again, just too clear. Prize money, $140,000. So you want to stay up there, even with a quick four-fault round, because the prize money and world ranking points are still up for grabs. Let's see. She sits up. She has to add a little bit of leg there at B. Jumps up. Great. Also, this horse jumps up high, can land a little shallow. Sometimes where other lines are a little bit tight for other horses, Hannah and Cloud sometimes need to move up a little bit. Fits this in. Good strong ride there. You can see her really put the energy into the horse right on takeoff. Strong ride here. Gets over that. Outside leg on. Whoa, a little far away. Just got a little bit stuck out there on the turn. Has that down as well. Time 82.39. So just under that time allowed of 83 seconds. But with the two down, it'll be eight faults for Hannah Selick and Cloud. You can see just after that last double, just horse, I think, either thinking he was done, just bulging out a little bit to the right. Hannah really put that right leg on to try to keep them on the inside track, but just ended up a little far away from it, having to move up a little bit too much. Got a little bit of a flat jump there. All right, moving on to Brazil's Gabriel de Matos Machado and Everbelly W. 15-year-old Dutch-bred mare by Coleman, owned by Emily Wood. Actually, dam sire of this horse is Tolan R. Again, sitting on two clear. Let's see, a little bit far away there, but got a big jump. They're all jumping that Adequan Oxer really well. Whoa, big jump there as well. Oh, big and high over the wall. Actually helps set him up there for the five. Landed shallow so he could still add some leg. And there, just moved up a little bit on the inside track, a little bit on the angle. Just got there too early and a little bit too close. Choosing the above ground with the black and gray poles. To the Liverpool. And now he's setting up the triple. And light rub, but that stays up. But unfortunately, C coming down behind. Just looked like he shifted across it. And lost a little bit of height in the air and didn't get quite across the back pole. Nice jump there. The key flow feeds USA Oxer. Oh, they are just a little bit unbalanced. As he took off, you could see the hind legs. Just no chance to get out of the way. But gets over the last. He will finish up with three down for 12 faults. Time is 81.12 for Gabriel de Matos Machado and Everbelly W. So, two clear at the moment. And it is a little bit breezy out there and a little bit of a chilly day. It was actually a gorgeous morning. It was really sunny and still. And now the wind has picked up. It's a little bit cloudy. But at least it's dry. All right. 25-year-old from the USA, Summer Hill. Summer Hill sitting on La Belle SCF. 13-year-old mare by Dictator Van de Bos Landova with the Baldini One Mother. Source bred by Spyco's Farm. You can see it there with the SCF at the end of the name. Oh, a couple times we've seen that back pole, the Hermes Oxer, coming down. It's off of a rollback turn. Those orange solid poles, always trouble for the horse. They're just getting there a little bit early in the five. Has it on the way up. Jumps over the orange Oxer well. She's a little bit wide here. We'll keep an eye on her time. But she does choose the in-ground option with the white poles at the Liverpool. So most people may be taking the above-ground one with the gray, but we've seen a bunch jump that in-ground one, which is good. That means that the ground at both of them will stay equally as good. Getting the balance back. Jumps that beautifully. Over that oxer. Sitting on the two down at the moment. Gets over A. Just maybe leans a little bit forward with the upper body to have the front pole coming out there. And unfortunately, the last comes down as well. Total 16 faults. So four down on the course. Time is 82.31. So just under that time allowed, but with the four down for Summerhill and LaBelle. So we're making our way through the first half of this $140,000 Keflo Feeds USA CSI three-star Grand Prix. Let's see what the youngest rider in the class can do, 18-year-old from the USA, Ansgar Holters Jr. And he's sitting on Shenyang, the Gutinhaus LLC entry of the 16-year-old gelding by Choco Blue with the Grand Canyon mother. This horse, of course, jumped the Olympics in Tokyo for the Japanese team with Daisuke Fukushima. And such a Scopiors with a big stride. Whoa, oh, gets over it. That was amazing. Well, a little bit deep here, just too deep there at the Oxer. I think Ansgar to the wall, wanted to do one less, but Shenyang thinking they were a little too far away. So put one in, but popped over it, but then kind of screwed up the distance to the Oxer after. Loping on down to here, has A, touches B, gets over C. Steadies up for the four. Jumps that easy. Again, this is a really, really scopey horse with a big stride. Nice and easy in the eight. Here left to steady up. Really great reaction there for the horse. Jumps really away from the vertical at A. That was great. Clears the last. But we'll have those two down for a total of eight faults times 81.70. So that time allowed 83 seconds, only catching a couple of riders out, but you can see the riders are right in that 81, 82 second range. So time allowed right on from our course builder, Olaf Peterson Jr. It's proving to be a challenging but appropriate course for this three-star today. And let's see if the USA's Jimmy Toronto can add his name to the good list. He's sitting on the Isalu Incorporated and Jet Show Stables entry, Cochio Zed. 10-year-old gelding by Cannon with the Diamante Semele breeding. So similar breeding to Junior Cannon that we saw with Alex Matz. But I believe a different mother. Oh, popping that back pole. Again, horses just getting a little bit stuck and coming down on the back pole there. Big jump at the wall. You can see Jimmy's strong ride there to the Liverpool. Gave a great jump. A little bit on this angle, but a good jump at the Oxer. What option is he choosing? Looking like he's going for the left side, the above ground Liverpool. Strong ride there. Horse looking really careful. Oh, you can see Jimmy knowing that it was pausing a little bit and kind of just looking like it wasn't getting through it so easily. And looking like he will raise the white flag and wave his goodbye. So retirement in the round for Jimmy Toronto. And Coachio. So it was looking good. The horse just looking like he was getting a little extra sharp and careful and jumping up high. Just struggling to get out of that triple. All right. Moving on to the USA's Margie Goldstein Angle. I believe she is the eldest rider in the class, 65 years old, but that age only means tremendous experience, hundreds of Grand Prix wins under her belt. And she's sitting on Jack of Hearts, the Gladewinds Partners LLC entry of the 12-year-old Danish-bred gelding out of Heartbeat by the Bala Bay Duruway mother. This is quite a big horse, Margie. Of course, a petite little rider. But petite means nothing in this sport. If anything, it's a good quality because you're like light as a feather up there. But this is a big horse. Margie actually notoriously in her career always liking really big horses. I remember as a young rider myself, I used to look up to her and say, if she can do it and she can ride these big steeds, then I could do it. So very inspiring throughout the years to many, many riders. Good ride there. She lands a little bit out on the left track, more so than most people we've seen, but you can see she's galloping here, trying to make up a little bit of that time. Jumps over the left side there. Big ride in. She's going to have to steady up here. Oh, gets over B, gets over C. Sits up in the four. It's good. She's keeping that energy, keeping it active. It's over that two. No, a couple more than that. Four more jumps to jump. Strong ride there at the key flow feeds, USA Oxer. Sets up this last double. Gets over A. Come on, gets over B. One last to go. Sitting up and clears it. Well within that time allowed, 79.66, and clear for Margie Goldstein Angle and Jack of Hearts. So excellent round there, making it three, coming back for our jump off. Again, like I said, Margie's won hundreds of Grand Prix titles. Let's see if she could maybe do it again today. All right, three remaining before our halfway drag. We're going to see Mexico's Enrique Gonzalez sitting on Origi Van de Zeshoek. Origi Van de Zeshoek, 10-year-old gelding by Marius Claudius with the El Dorado mother. So we saw our last one bring our count up to three for the jump off. Gets over the wall. Moves up a little bit there to the Liverpool. Jumps that good. Choosing that left side Liverpool. Sets up there good. Steadies up for B. Horse, oh, just looking like he's a little bit shifty. From this camera angle, you can't see it, but that vertical really aiming right directly, not only into the crowd, but that big bank, and it really kind of holds the horses, and you can see this horse landed and shifted really even on landing. So you could tell he was just not quite focused, taking off there. Jumps this, gets through A and B. That double's actually riding better than I think people anticipated. Clears the last, but unfortunately does have that vertical at number nine after the triple. Four faults, time is 81.10. Going into seventh place at the moment for Enrique Gonzalez. And you can see the frustration on his face saying, wish I didn't have that down, because otherwise quite a good round. Again, thanks to our sponsor, Keyflow USA. It's proud to launch during Wellington International 2024 as the sole distributor of the British feed company Keyflow Feeds brands of horse feeds and supplements in the United States. All right, next up, we're going to see Canada's Tiffany Foster. ranked 24th in the world. She's sitting on Electric. 10-year-old Zangersada mare by Emerald with the Voltaire mother. Source former ride of Ken Farrington and Janja Friedrich Meyer Zimmerman. Looking good so far. Ooh, little stumble there on the landing. Not phasing Tiffany at all. A little bit on the right corner of that oxer, but with a well-seasoned rider like Tiffany, a little trip like that is not distracting. She just ignores it and keeps going. Chooses in the left side also at the option. Setting up this beautifully. You can see how still she is with her upper body. Great body control, just helping the horse and letting the horse jump the jumps versus kind of forcing him to, just letting the mare take her time to get through that delicate triple. She's looking really good so far. Very scopey horse, jumping easy. Oh, just rolling A coming through this last double. Actually, I hadn't seen the double come down at all, and unfortunately, having the last one down as well. Finishing up with the two down, eight faults, time is 78.80 for Tiffany Foster and Electrique. So super solid round, and then just the two coming down at the end. But nice pet there from Tiff, saying, frustrated, but can't be too unhappy. The horse actually jumped a beautiful round. All right, and our last one before we're going to take a short break at our halfway point, Israel's 38-year-old rider, Ashley Bond. Ashley's sitting on the Elon Ferreter entry, as well as Aurora Farms LLC and Ashley Bond show jumping of Elka de la Palme. Elka de la Palme is a 10-year-old mare by Cartoon with the Cannon mother. I think I saw something the other day. Ash said this horse just stepping up to this level. Whoa, she choosing to do one more there. And unfortunately, just getting a little bit too close. But I think this horse just moving up to this level. I think Ashley's had this horse, been developing it. And but this is a big step up for sure, because this is a big solid meter 50, meter 55, and three-star Grand Prix. Great jump there. Clearly a very scopey horse. Jumps easy. Wow, great jump that there. That was excellent. Horse really set herself and pushed off to jump that. Just a little steering there. Ashley doing such an incredible job getting the energy into the horses and creating that scope. Big push there. And gets over the last, unfortunately, just with that one down. You can see her shake her head. Four faults, time is 78.49. Very fast time, so she's sitting just in fourth place at the moment. So super solid round. She's got to be really happy with that. Like I said, just bringing that horse up to this level. That's going to be a top one for her, I think, in the future. All right, we're going to take our midway drag, and we will be back with you guys shortly. They're just going to take care of the ground and stay tuned for the remaining half of the $140,000 Key Flow Feeds USA CSI three-star Grand Prix.
The horse, the ultimate athlete, the best friend, the teammate. Once wild, they now place their unquestioning trust in us, in the ring, on the track, and in the field. At Keyflow, we hold a deep appreciation that horses choose to grant us humans the privilege to keep and to care for them. This sense of responsibility drives everything we do. We know that through health comes performance, so if we want their best, we've got to give them ours. Our mission to redefine equine nutrition began because there was a clear gap between what was available and what we knew was possible. We knew horse feed could be better, so we made it better. Better for those who need power and endurance to fuel performance. Better for those who need the best start in life to reach their potential. Better for those who seek marginal gains to reign supreme. Better for those who need the vitality to tackle new adventures. And better for those who seek longevity because they have more wisdom yet to share. Through science and innovation, we've developed a range of feeds that are easier for horses to digest, that deliver more nutrients, and that require lower feeding rates. We've engineered each steam extruded nugget, pellet, cooked grain, and drop of oil for the health of the horse. So with every feed, you can trust that you're doing your very best for them. Keyflow Feeds, redefining equine nutrition because horses rely on us.
Find the balance with my family, with the horses, that is my passion. Work with the horses every day to do what I love. I used to have like one passion was the horses, and now I have two with my daughter. So I really want to have this balance in my life. I'm Marie Écart, I'm a professional show jumper representing France, and I'm Lola's mom. Be mindful, be present, turn on your brain.
Champion Equine Insurance. Unparalleled knowledge, integrity, and customer service to provide the best protection.
Detail. Getting to the destination the most efficient way possible. Ensuring all individual elements are working together to drive high performance. And making sure you do it consistently. Being the best comes down to perfect execution. That's not just good show jumping. That's good railroading. We love a sport that rewards precision.
To your golf car experience. We have an extensive range of new and refurbished inventory, and our team will fulfill all your sales, service, and rental needs. Whether you're teeing it up on the course, cruising through the neighborhood, or at the campground with family and friends, We have options to fit each and every lifestyle. Experience the Deaver difference, built on a tradition of excellence and service since 1978.
I'll take us into the second half of this $140,000 key flow feeds USA Grand Prix. And resuming with another top 10 rider in the world. Well, number 10 is Richard Vogel to start us off. And Richie, having won the Grand Prix in Geneva in December, one of the major Rolex Grand Prix, and of course the Rolex Grand Prix here in Wellington as well, into 2023 as well. Now today riding the Coleridge Equestrian's upcoming 10-year-old, the Hanoverian by Cascadello, is Sidelo for Richard Vogel of Germany. Finishing with a clear, Richard Vogel and Sidelo at 79.47. The top 10 riders swiftly delivering with a clear and clearer at number 4 of this Grand Prix here this afternoon. And so it's 1 for Germany, USA in there as well. And now it is 4 into the mix. So Richard Vogel joining Marci Goldstein-Engel, Andrew Wells. Caroline Winnie now, and the teenage US rider, already with wins together last week as well as part of WEF. Caroline from Woodside, California, with her own car CZ. Finish on a score of 4 in 81.97, just the one down, the orange and yellow for Sarah Seagull, and that's Stephen Jones finishing on 4 points. Great Britain's Jessica Mendoza now, and you ride her into her stream for the British European Championship with Nations Cup rider. This is Mark Martin's Kinmar quality hero, the Irish bred horse for Jessica Mendoza.
She's a little bit wide here. She gets over this. Sorry about that, guys. We were having some technical difficulties, but we're back with you. Looking at Jessica Mendoza and Kinmar Quality Hero. Still clear at the moment. She was a little bit wide. We'll have to keep an eye on her time. Little touch at B there, but gets over it. And again, want to keep an eye on her time allowed. She's just taking her time. Gets over the white skinny. Just coming down this last line, gets over the key flow, feeds Oxer. You can see her just trying to fit that stride in. Good job. Gets up over that. She's going to be a little bit on the edge with her time. Gets over the vertical. But over that time allowed, 83.99. She will pick up the one time fault, but she's sitting in fifth at the moment. So I believe we're still sitting on just the three clear, but... that was a solid round from Jess Mendoza, but just a little bit underpaced with the one time fault. All right. We're back looking at our second half of the $140,000 Key Flow Feeds USA CSI three-star Grand Prix. And next up, we're going to look at Canada's Susan Horn. 39-year-old rider, and she is sitting on Kirlo van de Bosrand, the Kingsfield Farm entry of the 14-year-old Belgian-bred gelding by Cardenta with Utrillo Z mother. Again, former ride of Sam Hutton and Abdel Saeed. And Susan representing her home nation of Canada. So course proving to be difficult enough. So far, only three clear. We've seen a couple clear jumping rounds, but with time faults. She has the second jump down. That's actually the first time we've seen that come down. Making space at the wall. Needs to steady up here. Then a little bit of leg at the end. Beautiful jump over the Liverpool Oxer. Needs to keep her leg on there as the horse kind of shook its head. She did a good job to kind of keep its focus. She's a little bit wide here. Gets straight to that black and gray Liverpool vertical. Now comes the delicate triple. Right to the base of A. Well, good skip move by the horse. You could see it just skip to help give itself a little bit more space in there. That was a super athletic move. Little bit of a slip in the ground there. It looks like the ground's getting a little bit slick on that turn. Not the first one we've seen slip there, but just a little bit too deep at that white vertical. Gets over the Key Flow Feeds USA jump. Good pat the ground there at A. Gets over it. And clears the last, but we'll finish up. Time is 82.28 with... two down for eight faults and Susan Horn. So just under that time allowed, but picking up the eight faults on the course. Nice little pet there. Solid round. But we will move on to a horse that jumped beautifully the other day. And let's see what Irish rider Shane Sweetnam can do. 12, ranked 12 in the world on the Longines World Ranking right now. RR Cumbella, owned by Shane Sweetnam and VoQuest LLC. 10-year-old mare by Cornette Dulys with the Indoctro mother. Really liked how this horse jumped the other day. Let's see if Shane can jump another round like that. Beautiful jump there. Really athletic jumper. Yeah, nice. Really jumps up high. Can see Shane really trusting the horse to use his scope, use her scope, use the power. And nice and soft. He's got a hackamore, so no bit in the horse's mouth. Keeps it nice and tight there. Jumps up high. A little bit of touch on the top of the pole, but that one stays up. Jumps B. Big ride out. Oh, maybe almost just a little bit too much coming out there at C. Just rolls that front pole out of the way. Pats the ground there at the vertical. A great jump there. This horse is just so sporty to see. Great jump there. And a little touch at the last, but clears it. Finishing up time 81.57 with the four faults. Sit in 13th place at the moment for Shane Sweetnam and RR Cumbella. Oh, that was a shame because I think that horse is really going to be a super one for Shane coming up. But next, we're going to take a look at Switzerland's Be It Manly. Be It is sitting on the Grant Road Partners GmbH and the Grant Road Partners LLC entry of Amira BZ. 10-year-old Zangerside Gelding by Aska Zed with the Concreto mother. He jumped clear in our qualifier, elected not to jump off on Friday, so saving the horse for today's class. And let's see if Amira BZ can add their name to our what is currently three-horse jump-off. Again, Be It won a 3-star on this horse a few months ago, so I think it's definitely coming into zone. Just 10 years old now, right into peaking age. This horse by Aska Zed, which is a Zangerside horse, really careful, and horses with the Aska and their pedigree tend to have really good front ends with a lot of blood. So I think we see that here with Be It's horse. He chooses to do the in-ground option on the right side with the white poles and that Liverpool set in the ground. Again, horses and riders having, or at least riders having the option to choose their, oh, unfortunately having C coming out. And then there just gets a little bit quick at the vertical, not jumping high enough to get over the key flow vertical there. So sitting on the two down at the moment. Great jump there. You can see it really grab the ground, push off. One left to go. Clears the last. Time is 80.98. With the two down, eight faults for Be It Manly and Amira BZ. Of course, sometimes with those riders, when you jump clear in the qualifier, of course, you always have the option to elect to not jump off if you don't want to. But big risk you take there by doing that. I understand, because people want to save the horses. And, you know, these horses have only so many jumps in them, so important to use them carefully. But, of course, you run that risk of having one or two down on Grand Prix day, and then you're always frustrated and say, I should have jumped off. But all right, let's see if Belgium's Nicolas Philippart's and Derby to Riverland can add their name to our jump off. 11-year-old Sel Francais gelding by Cannon with the L'Arc de Triomphe mother. Nicola jumping his first week here at the Winter Equestrian Festival for 2024. He's been here the last couple of years, comes over for Belgium with a string of horses, and he's been very successful every time he's come over here. Of course, such a super rider from a wonderful Belgian show jumping legacy family. Whoa, horse stutters off the ground there a little bit. Great strong ride by Nicola to get over that wall and then land, move up, make sure he gets there in the five. That was great reaction time from Nicola to make sure that he got there. See what he can do with the triple. Ooh, hard rub, has to straighten the horse a little bit, and then adds leg, gets through there, sits up in the four. So that was some really sharp riding by Nicola when the horse kind of shifted after A to get her back on track, get him back on track. Clears the last, got the last double, and see if he can do it. Clears A, gets over B, one left to go. He looks fine on the time. Clears the last and adding his name to the good list. 77.81 and clear for Derby to Riverland and Nicola Philipparts of Belgium. So that takes our count up to four on the good list so far. And again, remember, something new for this year. In the past, our qualifiers didn't actually take into account for the Grand Prix, whether or not they jump new orders of go, and this year we're doing reverse order of qualifying. So that means as we go through this start list, we're getting down the list of the ones that have actually jumped better and better in the qualifier, finishing up with our winners to go last in this class. So we'll see how this second half of this class plays out with the horses that look like they're kind of peaking this week. All right, next up for the USA, Vega Cata with Lucas Porter. Vega Cata, owned by the Sleepy Pea Ranch BV, and it's a 12-year-old mare by Vigo. Lucas also jumped really well the other day. It's also one of our clear rounds. Remember, we had 19 clear in our qualifier. So I think it's anybody's game finishing up the next 20 or so to go in this class, because they all jump clear on Friday's qualifier. So they're all in good form. Lucas looking good so far. Choosing the left option. Oh, but that comes down. Again, those black and gray poles. They're almost black and silver. Not so easy for the horses to see. Like I said in the first half, that option at number seven, neither of them are particularly friendly. It's either solid white poles with the in-ground ditch or the above-ground Liverpool with the black and silver poles. Neither are that friendly. Gets over the key flow, feeds USA Oxer. Jumps through the last double well. I will say that last double is riding better than I think the riders thought initially. It looked quite delicate at the end, but they're actually jumping it beautifully. But he will pick up the one down for faults. Time is 79.84 for Lucas Porter and Vega Cata. So we recently saw Nicola Philipparts add his name to the good list. Four so far clear. And again, thanks to Keyflow USA, we provide the tools for horses to perform their very best from the inside out. It's our passion and our mission. There you can see Keyflow for today's title sponsor of the CSI 3-Star Grand Prix. All right, next up, 22-year-old American rider Ashley Vogel. Ashley Vogel is sitting on Sarah Van Het Mooshoff, the 12-year-old Sel Francais mare, Biogana Sitta, with the Mozart de Hayet's mother, owned and ridden by Ashley herself. Looking like she had the first jump down, unfortunately. always a frustrating jump to have down. We saw a couple people rub it quite hard, but now it comes down for Ashley. Clears the wall, has to sit up, fit in that five here. Good jump at the Oxer. Again, only with four clear, so a quick four-fault round could definitely keep you up in the placings today. So I think people need to be cognizant of that as they're going around, knowing there aren't so many clear. Again, I'm sure we'll see a couple of more by the end. Oh, just hooks that a little bit behind. Got a little bit quick with the arc of the jump. Similar thing there. That one comes down in front. The other one was behind. But similar type thing, just the arc of the jump a little bit too flat and a little bit too quick across it. That's why those verticals coming down. Just this last double and the last one to go. Gets through the double. And clears the last, but we'll pick up those three jumping faults. 12 penalties times 81.64. Put her into 27th place at the moment for Ashley Vogel and Sarah Spanhet-Molsoff.
Alright.
Next up to go, USA's Lucy Delorier. 24-year-old rider. She is sitting on Jovaro and the Luja LLC entry of the 10-year-old Dutch-bred stallion by H5 Alvaro with the Ecuador mother. Lucy also jumped a great first round in our qualifier on this horse. It's a really, really scopey horse. Just 10 years old, coming up to this level. I think it hasn't jumped so many big, big classes. But Lucy's such a good rider. And this horse, very simple, but very important that she just gives the horse space and time to jump the jumps. He has a really big jump, but he needs a little bit of time on takeoff to make sure. Yep, there you see a little bit. Just not able to get that front end out of the way. Sometimes gets a little bit insecure when he's a little bit deep. But again, young and a little bit green at this level, so that will certainly come as he develops and gets more experience. Jumps that Liverpool beautifully. She chooses the one on the right. So that option with the white poles and the in-ground Liverpool. A good, sits up at B. That was a really good reaction. There, he really used his body well to get over B. There we go. This horse takes her nicely to the jump. Gets across the key flow. Just needs to sit up here at A. Yeah, very good. Jumps up and around A. Looks good at B. One left to go. Jumps the last beautifully. Nice space there at the last. She'll finish up just with that one down. Four faults. Time is 83.87. So just over our time allowed, she'll actually pick up a total of five faults with the one on the clock for Lucy and Jovaro. Solid round. Just green at this level. He's stepping up nicely, though. Super brave horse and obviously very scopey. Okay, moving on to the USA's Kathleen Driscoll. Kathleen Driscoll sitting on Hidalgo, the Don Stewart entry of the 11-year-old Dutch-bred gelding by Katoki with the Kidam de Ravel mother. Kathleen been very successful the last couple of years up at this high level. Very competitive rider. A little bit of a left to right angle at one. She's really on the direct line here to the Attaquan Oxer. Jumps up well around the Hermes. right up to the base there, maybe a little bit deep, but jumps around it great. Nice and simple. Hidalgo here, very scopey. Of course, by Katoki, we see a lot of nice horses by Katoki. They all have kind of a nice lopey gallop. And all quite scopey, simple minded horses. And the mother on this horse's side was by Piedame de Revel, which is one of the most popular breeding stallions back in the day. Real foundation sire for our sport. And actually, it was one of the first stallions used as frozen semen globally. So, interesting fact about Piedame. She's looking good so far. Whoa, just having to do one more at the end. Good effort to fit it in, and she's within the time, 81.50, and clear for Hidalgo and Kathleen Driscoll. So she was clear in our qualifier, clear again here in the Grand Prix. That was a great effort at the last line. That did not work out the way I think that she had intended or wanted to, but she just kept on fighting till she got through those timers, which is key when you're up there. Not everything happens perfectly. Sometimes things just don't work out the way you want, and you got to adapt quickly. And Kathleen did a great job there to fix that and clear the last. All right, moving on to the USA's Michaela Langmeyer. She is sitting on Pepita van der Rolebeek, the 9-year-old Belgian bred mare owned by Linda Langmeyer and by Otangela. Again, Michaela also was clear in our qualifier. Let's see if she can do it again. Big jump there. I think Michaela does such a good job. She keeps things real simple, sort of natural feel up there. Nice classic position. She has sort of a light seat. She keeps her hands sort of nice and high, direct line from her elbow to the horse's mouth. Little bit of a long gappy distance in there, and I think maybe that's why B catches up with her. She was just a little bit loose and lacking maybe a little bit of that compressed balance at takeoff at A, and then just gets a little bit flat at B. Remember, B, the tallest vertical out there, and it is just not working out so well for the horses and riders when the balance isn't just right. Gets through the last double. Stays on the inside track to the last and unfortunately rolls that. Maybe got there a tiny bit early at the end, so she will pick up the two penalty faults, eight faults total, and a time of 80.38 for Michaela Langmeyer and Pepita van der Rolebeek. So again, five clear so far. We've seen just two in this second half go clear. Sorry, we actually missed one during our technical difficulty. Richard Vogel actually was also clear. So he was our fourth. And then fifth being Nicola Philipparts, and sixth was Kathleen Driscoll just recently. All right, moving on to USA's Ninja J.W. Vanda Morhova and Sloane Coles, the Ninja Group entry of the 11-year-old Belgian bred mare by Elvis Deputa with the Cashmere Mother. Sloane jumped an exceptional round the other day in the qualifier, and she almost won the class, but had the last down. She had the time, but had the last one down in the jump off. But this horse really jumped a super round. Really scopey horse. Sloane, of course, such a good rider. Setting this up here. Chooses to take the left-hand side of that option. Setting this up good. Little reach across. Oh, and just haven't beat down like we've seen come down over and over. Those two jumps, B, and then that vertical after the triple, really coming down a lot today. Unfortunately, they're knocking a bunch of people out of that jump off. Here you can see Sloan just trying to get the balance back, having a discussion with the horse. Come on, help me out a little bit. Gets over the last. Unfortunately, we'll pick up those two down on the course. Total of eight faults, 81.29 for Sloan Coles and Ninja JW Van de Morhova. So, had a super round on in our qualifier, but picks up the two down today. All right. We'll move on to Daisy Farish of the USA, 23-year-old rider sitting on Orwell SCF, the Lane's End show jumping entry of the 10-year-old Belgian bred gelding by Dictator van de Boslandova with the Heartbreaker Mother. Again, the second Spycoast Farm bred entry. So that means it's an American bred horse, Orwell SCF. Formerly seen under Tanner Korotkin and David O'Brien of Ireland. The mother of this horse, the Heartbreaker Mother, actually jumped 140 herself. So, well-bred animal. Wow, look at that. You see the horse really kick out behind, not wanting to touch anything. Beautiful jump. This horse has a big gallop. You can see really active hind leg, big front gallop. Really grabs the ground. Strong ride there. Reaches across the back of that orange and yellow oxer. Daisy gave a great ride in the qualifier on Friday. She chooses that left option. This horse looks like it has a nice sort of rocking gallop. Beautiful opening up behind. Sits up for the four. Really good job there. This horse, you can really see how the hind end works. Really opens up, very athletic. And a super expression. Horse looks like it's really enjoying its job. You see the ears forward. Took her time there to jump that. One left to go. I think she's okay on the time. She's right on the edge, but oh, heartbreak at the last. She will pick up the four faults at that final fence time, 81.26, putting her into 16th place, unfortunately, with that final fence coming down for Daisy Farish and Orwell. Oh, what a heartbreak that must feel like. She had a super round. Not her day today. All right, moving on to USA's 24-year-old rider, Natalie Dean. Natalie Dean is sitting on the Marigold Sport Horses LLC entry, Nespresso Van Lakoff. The 11-year-old Belgian-bred gelding by Cicero with the Grandeur Mother. Former ride of Aaron Ballard of Canada. But now the young Natalie Dean. Six on the good list so far. Natalie was really good in our young rider class earlier in the day. Big jump there at the wall. This horse has lots of scope. Of course, Natalie just started working with reigning Olympic champion Ben Mayer. So it's a new working relationship between those two, but it looks like it's going well so far. Sets up the oxer, coming into the double. Now she has to really sit up. Yeah, jumps good there at B. Opens up great at C. Sits up for that. Looking really strong here. Great jump there. A couple more to go. She's looking good. Keeps the energy there up to the key flow feeds USA oxer. One more to go. She looks good on the time. Using her upper body. Great jump at the last time. 78.49. Adding her name to the good list. Nice smile on her face. She should be happy with that round. Bringing our count up to 7 now on the list to return for our jump off of this $140,000 Keflo Feeds USA CSI 3-star Grand Prix. It's our concluding class of the FEI competition of week 2 here at the Winter Equestrian Festival. Let's see if Ireland's Paul O'Shea can keep it going and add his name on the Trelawney Farm LLC entry, Oil Lily Van Eigenlo. 10-year-old Belgian bred mare by Vigo Darsui with the Montender mother. Source also jumped a great round on Friday. Beautiful jump. Really jerks her knees up. You can see her kind of drop her head and neck over the jumps. Yeah, look at that. Amazing, actually. You see the way that this horse jumps sort of in that beautiful shape. That really comes from the Vigo Darsui, the father of this horse, which of course was the world championship gold medalist with Philippe Lejeune back in Kentucky in 2010. Beautiful way of jumping and really good characters. It's looking good. He's got the one down so far. Jumps in good here. Oh, a little bit tight there in the last double, but a beautiful jump from the horse. Great effort on the horse's part. Oh, and has the last one down as well. Just maybe got a little bit quick at the end. He'll finish up at 82.29, just under that time allowed, but with the two down for 8 faults for Paul O'Shea and Oil Lily.
On to Lily now, Lily Keenan and the Chaslet Farm of New York, Sagana Van Hintet.
All right, so 7 clear and 6 remain.
And Monterrey, Mexico, and last year's
next up, USA's 27-year-old superstar rider, Lily Keenan. Lily Keenan sitting on the Chansonette Farm LLC entry, Agana Van Het Garandal Zed. The 13-year-old Zangerside Stallion by Agonix with the Topaz mother. She was super the other day, finished 6th in our qualifier, double clear round. This horse could be really fast. She's had this horse since it was a young one, developed it from its 6-year-old. Of course, I knew this horse as a really young horse because it's from my neighborhood. It was in my backyard, basically. Developed in Europe by a girl named Jill Verheim, who did a super job before Lily took over the ride. This horse has tons of blood. Won a World Cup qualifier with Lily a couple of years ago out west. A little bit deep there. Lily said she chose to jump that one so that it would help hold the horse to jump over that Liverpool. So she chose the one with the white poles. Sits up here, gets over B, really good. Jumps out of that easy. Beautiful jump there. Lily has such a great connection with the horse. You can see she's such a strong rider up in the saddle. She's never moving, very secure. Does what she needs to do to get things done. This is looking good so far. A couple more to go. Jumps A. Beautiful jump across B. One left to jump. I think she gets there easy in the 7. Clears that, and there we go. Another clear, 81.48, and clear for Lily Keenan. So she was clear in our qualifier, clear again today. Big hug for Augie. Makes a smile on Lily's face. Oh, look at that. You can see she is proud of her steed. That was a super round. She should be proud. She
Rode great on Friday. Rode great here today. Very precise ride by Lily. She'll be back for our jump off. All right, next up for Venezuela, Luis Fernando Larrazabal and Condora. The Victoria Huertamonte entry and Luis Fernando Larrazabal on the 12-year-old Mecklenburg mare by Conthargos with the Catapult 7 mother. This horse also jumped a great round on Friday. I really like this horse. Something about it, really sporty. I think Luis does a really good job with it. Oh, unfortunately, having the second jump down, we haven't seen that one come down too much in the class, but it's caught a couple of people out. Beautiful jump there. Lands a little bit deep after the orange oxer. Big jump. Wow, look how beautifully it opened up there behind. Ooh, a little stumble on takeoff. That's not the place you want to stumble. That would be an uncomfortable feeling for the rider and the horse. But recovers, keeps on going. So had that early fence down, and now he's just going to want to be neat. Again, 8 clear at the moment. I think placings of world ranking points goes all the way up to 16th place. Take a look at the prize money breakdown before our jump off. Looking good here, just trying to be quick. Balances up here. Ooh, jumps really good around that. Little reach out. Keeps the right leg on, stays on it to the last. Clears that. But we'll pick up the unfortunate early fault at number 2, times 78.07 with the 4 faults. Puts him into 10th place, so that was a quick round. I think just behind our time faulters with the quick 4 faults for Luis Larrazabal. And Condora. All right, 4 left to jump in this first round, sitting on the 8 clears at the moment. Let's take a look at the young American rider, Elena Ejas, on her own entry, Claude. Just 20 years old, one of the youngest riders in the class. Claude is a 12-year-old Westphalian gelding by Captain Jack with a Cephalo mother. Let's see if she can do it. Elena was good in our meter 50 yesterday. Beautiful jump here. Elena's young at this level, but she's got a lot of horses, so she's getting tremendous experience jumping lots of different horses in all the big classes and all the FEI classes each week. She's got a great opportunity to improve and really excel at this sport with so many chances. Beautiful ride in there. Sits up great. See? And jumps it easy. When you get the right shot in there, she really used her upper body really to help that. That was executed perfectly. Gets right up to the base. Horse just pats the ground to jump that delicate white vertical. Beautiful jump. Ooh, little bit of a touch at the back pole there, but that stays up. She's looking good so far. I think her time is okay. Stays on it to the last. And look at that. Super clear round into our jump off, 81.15. Big smile on her face. That was an absolutely beautiful round laid down by Elena Ejas, the young rider out of America, looking like she was perfectly on form. She didn't make a single error anywhere on course. A little bit of a rub at that oxer near the end, but great round. She should be happy with that. All right, moving on to the first of our remaining 3. Ireland's Kian O'Connor. The Pat Crean entry of Highland President. Pat and Lisa, green entry. 12-year-old Dutch-bred gelding by Clinton with the Cannon mother. Kian finished third in the meter 50 yesterday. He was third also in the Challenge Cup on Friday. So he's having a good weekend here. And I think he was actually pretty good in last night's National Grand Prix as well. Of course, Olympic bronze, individual bronze medalist. There we go. Looking good so far. Beautiful jump there. Kian so calm and chill under pressure and such top management with the horses. Ooh, a little bit deep, but that was an unbelievable jump. You could see it really loaded the power on the takeoff for a super strong, scopey, careful jump at that Oxer. That was great. Talk about putting energy into a horse. Kian just did that to a T. Horse having a lot of blood, strong ride, has to really sit up. Oh, good job there. Little bit of leg out, fitting in the four, and then softening so the horse can use its head and neck at the vertical. Jump that great. Whew. Takes the big one there, gets a little bit close with the hind end, gets over it. Couple more to go, looking good. Now just needs to keep it together, jump through the double. One left to go. Time looks fine. Active to the last. Oh, what a shame. Last jump down. Four faults times 78.40. He'll go into 12th place at the moment. That was a shame. You can see him shake his head there in frustration because the horse jumped great. Tyndon was getting a little bit lower over the white vertical up at the top and just not able to clear it at the last. Oh, disappointing. Pointing for Kian, but that is certainly a horse for the future. All right, moving on to the first of our remaining two, Abigail McArdle for the USA and Olympia Van Het Eikenhoff. Her owned entry of the 10-year-old Belgian bred mare by Elvis Deputta, owned by Sweetwater Jumpers LLC. Of course, she was our tied winner from the Challenge Cup on Friday. She is second to last here to go in today's three-star Grand Prix presented by Keyflow Feeds USA. She was really fast in our jump off the other day. Let's see if she can add her name to this good list. Nine clear at the moment. Beautiful jump there. Also really good job there. You can see use her seat, her leg. Keep the connection, create the energy, get a powerful jump there. Tight turn back. She chooses the option on the right, the solid white poles with the in-ground Liverpool. Little bit of a reach there. Oh, too close at B. Coming down like we've seen time and time again in this class. B of that triple proved to be very hard jump to jump. Big jump there at the Keyflow Feeds Oxer. She'll have to just keep it together to jump this double. Little bit of leg out. Keeps it active to the last. Clears that, but unfortunately with B coming down to the triple, she'll have to settle in 23rd place with a time of 81.86 on the four faults for Abigail McArdle. And Olympia, good pet for the horse. It was another solid round, but sometimes you just have one down. That's the way it goes in our sport. We've got one left to go. Nine on the good list so far. Let's see if we can make it an even 10 with Great Britain's Amanda Derbyshire and Cornwall BH. The Amanda Derbyshire and Gotchman Sport Horses LLC entry of the 16-year-old gelding by Conair with the Cambridge 8 mother.
good so far. This wall can be spooky. I've actually not seen any real trouble. A couple paused at it, but no trouble for Cornwall. She's just got to keep the balance. Such a strong rider, Amanda is choosing that left side. She's a small woman, but she is super strong up there in the tack. Oh, yeah, look at that. Really sits up, fits that in. Then you can see her ad leg. Little bit of pressure to get out of the triple. Stays on the inside track here. She'll be well within our time. Neat turn back, nice space. Couple left to go. She's looking good so far. Gets over the key flow feeds. Oxer steadies up here. Ooh, a little bit of a gap coming in. Jumps through B. One left to go. And will she do it? No, she will not. She has the last one down. Unfortunately, that'll put her into 16th place. Time is 79.86. Look at the frustration on her face. That last jump caught a lot of people out today and kept them out of the jump off. So no glory for Amanda Derbyshire today, but that means we are going to see 9 coming back for our jump off of this Key Flow Feeds CSI 3-star Grand Prix jump off qualifiers. Let's take a look at this list. First one, Catherine A. Dinan of the USA. Then we're going to see Andrew Wells, Margie Goldstein Engel. We'll move over to Germany's Richard Vogel. Then fellow European, the Belgian Nicola Philipparts, and then back to the USA, Kathleen Driscoll, Natalie Dean, Lily Keenan, and Elena A. Haas. Lots of women in our jump off. Love to see that. But it's going to be an exciting jump off. We saw the appropriate number of clears. It was a tricky, difficult course, but perfect for our 3-star. We're going to get an exciting jump off in this Key Flow Feeds USA CSI 3-star Grand Prix here to conclude week 2 of the Winter Equestrian Festival. Stay tuned with us, and we will be back with you guys shortly for the conclusion of our class.
The horse, the ultimate athlete. The horse, the ultimate athlete, the best friend, the teammate. Once wild, they now place their unquestioning trust in us, in the ring, on the track, and in the field. At Key Flow, we hold a deep appreciation that horses choose to grant us humans the privilege to keep and to care for them. This sense of responsibility drives everything we do. We know that through health comes performance, so if we want their best, we've got to give them ours. Our mission to redefine equine nutrition began because there was a clear gap between what was available and what we knew was possible. We knew horse feed could be better, so we made it better. Better for those who need power and endurance to fuel performance. Better for those who need the best start in life to reach their potential. Better for those who seek marginal gains to reign supreme. Better for those who need the vitality to tackle new adventures. And better for those who seek longevity because they have more wisdom yet to share. Through science and innovation, we've developed a range of feeds that are easier for horses to digest, that deliver more nutrients, and that require lower feeding rates. We've engineered each steam extruded nugget, pellet, cooked grain, and drop of oil for the health of the horse. So with every feed, you can trust that you're doing your very best for them. Key Flow Feeds, redefining equine nutrition because horses rely on us.
My my first goal when I decided to be a professional, it's to become like the best horsewoman I can be. It's really important for me to find the balance with my family, with the horses, that is my passion. Work with the horses every day to do what I love. I used to have like one passion was the horses, and now I have two. It's my daughter, so I really want to have this balance in my life. I'm Marie Écart, I'm a professional show jumper representing France, and I'm Lola's mom. Be mindful, be present, turn on your brain.
Champion Equine Insurance. Unparalleled knowledge, integrity, and customer service to provide the best protection.
Just good show jumping. That's good railroading. We love a sport that rewards precision.
Golf Car Experience. We have an extensive range of new and refurbished inventory, and our team will fulfill all your sales, service, and rental needs. Whether you're teeing it up on the course, cruising through the neighborhood, or at the campground with family and friends, we have options to fit each and every lifestyle. Experience the Deaver difference, built on a tradition of excellence and service since 1978.
All right, we are back with you guys for the conclusion of the CSI three-star $140,000 Key Flow Feeds USA Grand Prix. And our trailblazer from round one, USA's Catherine A. Dynan and Brego R&B. They saw the clear. They were second to go in our original list, and they were the pathfinders. Nice little pet there. She's just surveying the land, getting a feel for where she wants to go, relaxing her pony, and she will get us started in this jump off. We've got nine combinations to see for the conclusion of the Key Flow Feeds USA 3-star Grand Prix at WEF 2. We've been out on the field all week here. Olaf Peterson Jr. built these FEI courses. He's done an excellent job. We saw the perfect number of clear in today's 3-star Grand Prix. And let's see what the jump off is. Starts off the left at number 2. See the original 2. Left to right angle for Katie. Now it's going to be right-hand turn, kind of around the bank to a new obstacle, vertical at number 15. She'll go around here. Long run down to BC of the triple. That's vertical Oxer in the one stride. Jumps great there. Has to do the steady 4. Oh, horse really backed up great. She goes just around. A little bit slippery on this turn here. It's been a little slick all class. Clears that vertical. It's no longer solid white poles. Gets over the Key Flow Feeds Oxer. And long run down to the last. Let's see what she does. Clears the last. Time is 39.75. That will become our automatic leader with the double clear for Katie Dinan and Brego R&B. So 39.75, double clear, and that becomes our time to beat. But that started really well. I think maybe she was a tad bit conservative, but you got to leave all the jumps up, and she managed to do that. So let's see if the USA's Andrew Wells can catch her. He's sitting on idle H&H. The Itasca Group LLC and Evergreen Stables LLC entry of the 11-year-old Dutch-bred gelding. Andrew jumped a beautiful first round. Let's see if he can catch the time set by Katie Dine in 39.75. So she puts the pressure on. Jumps that good. Now long run down to the double. Remember BC, so it's the vertical Oxer one stride. I don't think we'll see anyone attempt to do 3 after. He has the vertical coming in down at A. Clears that. Nice and balanced here. Gets over the vertical. Again, those poles changed out to a striped pole instead of the solid white. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Does the 10, nice and easy. Gets through it. Time is 40.54. But with the one down, that'll put him, of course, automatically into second place. Just off that pace. Katie's time was 39.75. Andrew, just over 40 seconds. So Katie certainly put the pressure on. And again, now everyone's got to leave the jumps up. And let's see if Margie Goldstein Angle can overtake Katie Dinan. She's sitting on the Glade Winds Partners LLC entry, Jack of Hearts. 12-year-old Danish-bred gelding by Heartbeat. Margie jumped a beautiful first round. And now she's going to have to be quick. Like I said in the first round, Margie has hundreds of Grand Prix wins to her name. Let's see if she can add another one today. They seem to be choosing to come off the left, get that left to right angle. Good push at the Oxer. And now Margie's off to the races. Steadies up a little bit there. Long run across the middle here, kind of in between these water elements. And then you got to steady up a little bit. Whoa, she's coming in strong. She gets over it. Whoa, good job. Jumps great there. Steadies up in the 4. Ooh, didn't really finish the stride behind, but manages to get over it. That was a little bit lucky. Good there. A little touch. Gets over that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Clear. 40.50. So into second place, 40.50. but just off the pace. On the double clear, putting her into second. 40.50 is about 7/10 of a second slower than our leader, Katie Dinan and Brego R&B. All right, now let's see if Germany's speedmaster, Richard Vogel, can take over the lead with Sidello, the Coleridge Equestrian LLC entry, as well as Richie's himself. 10-year-old Hanoverian gelding by Cascadello with the Forsyth mother. Unfortunately, I missed the first round of Richie's, saw that he was clear. So let's see. As everyone knows, Richie is one of the fastest riders in the world. Let's see if he can be fast and leave the jumps up today. Well, he's got a hell of a running start. Very quick. This horse, a lot of blood. Super careful. Richie is on an unbelievably fast pace here. Now he's just got to keep it organized. Jump A, jump B. Steady up in the four. Nice space there. That was really good. He's going to be quick. They're all going around that little flower pot. I don't think going inside is going to help anybody. Whew. Gets over that. Whoa, does the leave out really far away. Let's see if he can leave the jumps out. Whoa, he's kicking, he's kicking, he's kicking. Can he do it? He does. Look at that time, 36.32. That was something. So Richie Vogel becomes our automatic leader, taking over the lead, 36.32. That was an incredibly fast round. Look at him shake his head. I think he's thinking about that penultimate fence that he did the leave out to it. He's smiling because that was a speedy round and he knows it. All right, so that becomes our time to beat, 36.32 on the double clear. Richie Vogel going into the lead. Let's see if Belgium's Nicolas Philipparts can catch him. He's sitting on Derby to Riverland. The team Philipparts and Pierre Simolai entry of the 11-year-old Sel Francais gelding Derby to Riverland. Again, time to beat, 36.32. Richie was lightning fast. Oh, he's on an angle there. He's pretty quick. Now he's got to run. Richie really opened up the stride here. Oh, Nicholas, pretty good. He's coming in quick. He's got to slow it up. Yep, good job. He used his body to really help slow the arc of the jump down. Jumps that one good. Now he's got to keep going. And here's where Richie started to take some big chances. He's got to kick and get it done. So he does one more stride than Richie did. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Gets over it, but does not catch him. 37.69. Very fast, but not fast enough. 37.69 into second place for Nicolas Philipparts and Derby to Riverland. Again, that was a great effort on Nicolas' part, but you got to remember, Richie Vogel was lightning. I don't know if anyone is catching Richard Vogel today, but that was a great effort from the Belgian rider and sitting in second at the moment. All right, next up for the USA, Kathleen Driscoll and Hidalgo, the Don Stewart entry of the 11-year-old Dutch-bred gelding by Katoki. Kathleen also jumped clear in our qualifier. She had a beautiful round today. This is a little bit of a slower mover than Richie's horse, but has a really big stride. So let's see if Catherine can just stay on it, the pace, and keep her track as neat as possible. She's looking good. She's gonna have to keep moving. Bulging a little bit left here. Maybe does another stride or so than Richie. And she's gotta keep moving here. And she slows up a bit early. Steady, jumps A, she gets through B. Steady's up in the four, and now somebody's got to be quick. Yeah, let's see if she does it. She's going. Gets the seven like Richie. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Gets it done. But 38.79, putting her into third at the moment. So Richard Vogel's time of 36.32, still holding. But Kathleen Driscoll finishing up, holding in third place at the moment, 38.79 on the double clear. Beautiful round for Kathleen, sitting in third at the moment. So good effort there. But a couple more to see. Three more to jump off. Natalie Dean and Nespresso Van Lakoff, the Marigold Sport Horses LLC entry. Let's see if she can try to catch Richie Vogel's time of 36.32. This horse has a big stride. She can cover a lot of ground. She's good there. Now she's got to run. Oh, she's got to go faster than that, I think, if she's going to catch Richie. Big jump in there. Oh, backed up. Just got there a little bit too early. Has beat down. You can see she jumped in really big to the double. Horse really tried to back up, but was just kind of on top of B. Gets the seven. Long there, but gets it. And then steadies up to the last. And gets through the timers. Time 38.16, but with the four faults, that will put her into sixth place at the moment for Natalie Dean and Espresso Van Lakoff. Again, Richard Vogel still leading with Sedello, 36.32 is our time to beat. Let's see if the speedy Lily Keenan and Agonavant Van Het Garendal Zed with the Chansonet Farm LLC entry of the 2011 Zangerside Stallion by Agonix can catch Richard Vogel. Now, Lily can be super fast on this horse. This is an ultra careful horse. Very competitive. So, and Lily herself is a competitive rider. She is going to try. But let's see if she can catch Richard Vogel. First of our remaining two in the jump off for this three-star Grand Prix. She's off to a big gallop. There we go. She's going to have to run if she wants to win this. It's a little bit conservative there. Clears it a little bit of a rub. But she's got to keep pushing. Come on, Lily. Keep pushing. Organizes here. Ooh, she has a lot of speed. Oh, great jump there from Augie. Come on, Agana. Oh, she's going inside. We haven't seen anyone else do that. Good for her to make that turn. Really tight back. Now she's got to go. She landed a little bit dead. Not going to be able to get the seven. Gets the eight. But now she's got to run to the last. Come on. Got to keep going. Got to keep going. Gets over the last, but doesn't catch him. 39.17 into fourth place, about 2.8 seconds off the time. 39.17. And on the clear, but into fourth right now. So good effort from Lily's part. Got a little, she went inside to get that sharp turn back to the third to last jump, the vertical up at the top. But it did kind of park her a little bit at that vertical, and she wasn't able to get the seven coming to the oxer across the middle. All right, last to see. Can Elena Ahas and Claude catch Germany's Richard Vogel with that time of 36.32? She's sitting on Claude, the Elena Ahas owned and ridden entry. Keep moving across the middle. Looking good. Now she's got to run. Oh, she's opening him up. Let's see if she can get it. She's a little bit wider than Richie was. Steadies up and unfortunately gets a little bit too deep there. Has the front pole. Goes around here. So that means Richard Vogel is going to be the winner of today's three-star. But let's see what Elena finishes up on. Steadies up here to do the 8 to the Key Flow Feeds USA Oxer. Keeps moving to the last. Takes the big one at the last. Clears that. But with that one down, time 41.64, that will slot her into ninth place for the conclusion of this CSI three-star $140,000 class. So looking good so far, not so far, we're finished. Richie Vogel going to be our winner today. What an exciting jump off that was. And again, winner of this class going to pick up 33% of the prize, which will be $46,200 to our winner, Richard Vogel, and Sidello with that blazing time of 36.32 on the double clear. Second place is going to be Nicola Philippart with a time of 37.69 in Derby to Riverland. He's going to pick up $28,000 for 20% of our total pot. And in third place, we're going to see Kathleen Driscoll and Hidalgo picking up 10% of that prize money, $14,000 going to our third place. Nope, $21,000 finishing for our third place finisher. So what an exciting jump off that was. Of course, thanks to Keyflow Feeds for their sponsorship of this CSI three-star week here at the second week of the Winter Equestrian Festival, as well as the title sponsor of today's $140,000 Grand Prix. We saw 45 horse and rider combinations contest the first round course set by Olaf Peterson Jr. 9 made it into our jump off. And Germany's Richard Vogel coming out on top with the Coleridge Equestrian LLC entry, Sidello. That was an exciting jump off. A lot double clear and ultra, ultra fast from the master of faster. And there are our final results. First place, Richard Vogel of Germany. Then Nicola Philippart of Belgium. USA's Kathleen Driscoll in the third spot. Lily Keenan into fourth. Katie Dynan goes into fifth. Margie Goldstein Angle of the USA in sixth. Natalie Dean in seventh. Andrew Wells and his student Elena A. Haas will finish up eighth and ninth. And 10th place went to Jessica Mendoza. She was our time falter from the first round. And Luis Fernando Larrazabal in 11th with the fastest four faults. And Kian O'Connor rounding out the top 12 for our final results here in the Keyflow Feeds USA three-star Grand Prix prize-giving ceremony coming up shortly. But this was an amazing week of show jumping. Started out a bit rainy and soggy, finishing up a little cloudy and chilly and windy today, but at least it was dry. To conclude our second week of the Winter Equestrian Festival, that means we've got 10 more weeks of exhilarating FEI competition coming up. Next week, we'll be back over at the main showgrounds in the International Arena for week 3. And then week 4, we'll be back over here at the Global Pavilion for another week out on the grass for the 4-star coming up week 4. But this was an exciting day of show jumping. You can see they're just getting ready for the prize giving ceremony. Again, thanks to our title sponsor, Keyflow Feeds. And Richie Vogel, you can see him walking up there. I see a white cooler in the background. He, of course, our champion from today. What a super round that was. Now we're zooming in on those third, second, and first place finishers. Third, of course, Kathleen Driscoll. Second, Nicola Philippart. And first to Germany's Richie Vogel. This was a super fast jump off, very exciting. I hope you guys enjoyed our presentation. Again, thanks to Dodd Technologies for presenting our live stream. Dodd Technologies is an industry leader in creative design and technology support services for sports, entertainment, corporate, and special events. Visit us online at doddtechnologies.com. Also, today's live stream was presented also in part with the support of the U.S. Equestrian Federation and the USEF Network. Here you can see our top three coming in to the ring for their awards presentation. I got to think that Richard Vogel has got to be moving up those world ranking list very rapidly. Of course, he won the Rolex Grand Prix in Geneva, which was over €1 million in prize money. There's our third place finisher, Kathleen Driscoll. And
going forward in second place is for Belgium. That's Nicola Philippart in second with Derby de Riverland.
Hidalgo. And there's our second place finisher, Derby de Riverland, and Belgium's Nicola Philippart. He gave it a great effort. Wasn't able to catch Richie Vogel, but a well-deserved second place finish here in the Key Flow feeds. CSI 3-Star Grand Prix. And we're going to have our winner coming up. The horse looking excited. I'm sure the rider's excited. Look at that big smile. You can see those pearly whites all the way from here. And there's our winner, everyone. Champion of today's Key Flow Feeds CSI 3-Star Grand Prix, Richard Vogel of Germany and Sidello. Horse looking excited about his win. And nice thumbs up. I'm sure Richie is thrilled with that performance today. And now they're going to do a little victory lap. But I want to thank you guys all for joining us here. I'm Danny Waldman, and this has been a presentation of Key Flow Feeds, Dodd Technologies, and USEF. Thank you guys all for joining us, and stay tuned next week for another thrilling week of international competition. They're doing the national anthem of Germany now. And they will do their victory gallop shortly after this. There's that German flag being raised. And you can see how breezy and windy it is here in Wellington, Florida. But at least the sun is shining. It's supposed to warm up next week for us. But congrats to Richard Vogel, our winner of today's $140,000 Key Flow Feeds USA CSI 3-Star Grand Prix. And they're just finishing up that national anthem.
Very well done to
raising the German flag.
It is a fantastic congratulations to our top finisher there and to the winning groom as well. To
German
Wallace
anthem is actually a quite long anthem. But there we go. Helmet back on. And they will be off for their
going to the,
victory gallop very shortly.
Combination and also the International Rider Awards. And so that's this time we'll go to Lily Keenan.
Richie looking like he's preparing for that gallop. Another thumbs up. Off he goes. All right, congrats to our winners. Richard Vogel in first, Kathleen Driscoll in, Nicola Philippart's in second, and Kathleen Driscoll in third. Thanks again for watching, everyone. I'm Danny Waldman, and I will catch you guys next week here for week 3 at the Winter Equestrian Festival. See you guys on Thursday for the Challenge Cup, and we'll be back with you shortly.
Going forward to make the presentation of the Double H Farmer Groom's Award, $500 to the winning groom, and that going to Alicia Wallace. Congratulations to her, of course, the groom with the team for Richard Vogel and the Coleridge Equestrian. Fantastic result for that, and very well done for a wonderful finish. And now welcoming forward for that Martha Jolicoeur, leading FBI International. Awards presented this week by Michael and Wendy Smith. And they present to Lily Keenan, who finishes our top rider of the week across the classes for the Grand Prix and the Grand Prix qualifier as well. Congratulations to Lily, who completes the day as our final presentation of the week. We're back, of course, next week, and so we'll be back over the main.